Okay, everyone. So today we're going to take a look at the Driver Plus feature. Now, this is not like the Tesla Autopilot. This system, you have to be attentive. And I found that when vehicles are close to you in the next lane, you still have to be careful because the truck won't necessarily see a car that's there and move out of the way. So, nonetheless, when you're able to use Driver Plus on a pre-mapped highway, you'll see the little icon next to the speed limit sign in your display behind the steering wheel. And what you'll need to do is, just like the Tesla Autopilot, you'll double tap, and actually it didn't engage the auto steer. So let's go back here and try this again. Okay, so I turned it on. There we go, I have the blue line. Now I can adjust the speed up or down by hitting left or right. So if I hit right, it'll increase my speed. And if I tap left, it'll decrease my speed. And the scroll wheel, I can adjust the length of space I want to keep between me and the car in front of me. So I can go up, and it looks like there's four different settings. And I usually keep it in the bottom setting. That's a little less aggressive. It'll really slow down a lot if you keep it in the far setting. It'll slow down a lot for vehicles, especially when they cut in front of you, like that car just did. And you can see it does a really good job of keeping the vehicle centered in the lane and keeping an appropriate amount of space between the Rivian and the vehicle in front. However, one thing I've noticed is that when you're in the right lane, well, there's two things actually. When you're in the right lane, it doesn't necessarily pay too much attention to traffic that's merging in. So you could have a lot of drivers that are getting upset with you because you're not allowing them to merge in. The other thing that happens in the right lane is when you have a brake for an exit and it's on a turn, so it can either be a left-hand turn or a right-hand turn if it's a left exit. When that happens, I found a lot of times the truck wants to go off on the exit instead of keeping the turn, which is not good. So you really need to stay attentive when you have this engaged. It's not at all like the Autopilot, where it uses AI to detect objects and road lines and that kind of thing. One thing that's nice about the Rivian versus like a Tesla is the Tesla will require you to tug on the steering wheel or to hit one of the scroll wheels to let it know that you're still there. The Rivian steering wheel is capacitive. So all you need to do is put your fingers on the back of the steering wheel, or just rest your fingers on the back of the steering wheel, and it will know that you're there and it won't prompt you to grab the steering wheel. In many cases, the Driver Plus is going to be really all you need on the highway. The only complaint I have about it is that it's only available on pre-mapped highways, and it doesn't have automatic lane change, at least not at the time of this recording. And from what I'm reading online, I don't know how true it is, but what I'm reading online is that Rivian right now is not necessarily prioritizing enhancing the Driver Plus functionality. They're more focused on the actual infotainment software. I think they're going to be adding like streaming video and that kind of thing. But I hope at some point in the near future they do dedicate a little more time to the Driver Plus, because I think if it had automatic lane change and They updated it to be available on more pre-mapped highways. I think it would be a very competitive product to both Tesla Autopilot and the Ford Blue Cruise system, as well as GM's Super Cruise. But as you can see, it does a really good job of keeping me centered in the lane. Now, it does sometimes ping pong back and forth. So, for example, we're on I-70 right now. Sometimes the lanes kind of shift around, and the truck will actually shift around in the lanes, and it kind of makes some other drivers, you know, slow down, thinking you're maybe driving when you shouldn't be or something like that. But just keep that in mind. This is not a foolproof system. It's, as I'm sure you know, it's not meant to drive for you and allow you to be unattentive or hands off the wheel. This is very much a hands-on system and requires your full attention at all times. Now, at different times, the Driver Plus will prompt you to take over. For example, if it's a very curvy road, you will get a prompt from Driver Plus. It doesn't necessarily feel as comfortable on roads where there's a lot of curves and turns and that sort of thing. Also, just like Autopilot, the Driver Plus does not like weather conditions that are less than ideal. So if it's raining hard, if you have snow, if you have dense fog, you may run into issues with Driver Plus. It may prompt you to take over, or it may not even let you enable the functionality at all. So it's very similar to the other systems. It does rely on the cameras to function. But I think the system has a lot of promise. The only thing that concerns me a little bit is Rivian sent out an email, I would say within the past month or so, stating that they're going to be removing all of the driver-facing cameras. So up here, up in the top above the rearview mirror, there's a little camera. Now, my vehicle still has it in, but all the vehicles being produced currently do not have it. And I understand they're trying to save costs. However,
in a half mile, take exit 68.
That gives me some concern over whether or not Driver Plus is going to be improved over time, because they're taking away a camera that does driver monitoring. But then again, maybe Rivian has some way around that. But nonetheless, folks, it's a pretty good system. It's going to meet, I would say, 90%, 95% of everybody's needs out there. It's never going to be like Tesla's Autopilot, where you have the auto steer on city streets and all that kind of stuff. It's not going to be that kind of a system, but I think it can improve, and I really do hope that they add the ability for automatic lane change. I think that's one big feature that's missing. What do you think of Rivian's Driver Plus system? And how do you think they could improve it? Let us know down in the comments section. As always, folks, like, subscribe, hit the bell, and thanks for watching.